this again.
Marry, fuck, kill, anthro horse, anthro tiger, anthro rat. I already know your answers, actually. And the rat does not live. Still ain't met your ass. I can take care of myself. Go. T, call me, dog. I'm gonna come up to the kill. Blind sauce, snap hat, anthony, fantano.
I'm not answering any of these.
I kill Anthony Fantano because he keeps giving Animal Collective like a soft 7. I marry. Who's making more money? MatPat or Vine Sauce?
Vine Sauce or V Sauce? Because those are two different things.
Oh, V Sauce, sorry. I don't know why. I see that.
I would have to assume that MatPat's making way more money.
But, you know what? No, fuck it. I kill MatPat.
V Sauce takes so much longer to make his videos because his videos are good.
That's true.
MatPat doesn't spend.
I take it back.
Like he puts a lot of effort into his videos, but they're all like factory produced. They're
okay,
so fucking
so
mass produced.
I redact. I take back my statement. I kill MatPat. I mean, like you can't marry or like fuck up. I'm sorry. I like just to hear his like grating fucking voice in bed.
Oh wow! You're great!
No!
Fuck me harder, daddy!
Oh, what's there?
Does my cock get hard every time I see Daddy Merc? That's just a theory!
So I kill MatPat. Ritual, like, sacrifice style. I would put him on a rock and
horsey.
Stab him hard.
That's not a horse.
I would marry Vine Sauce and I'd fuck Anthony Fantano. He seems like he's a gentle lover. Because if I can marry Vine Sauce, then at least there's some money there. And I don't know. It's like you've seen Vine Sauce, Vsauce, Sauce, whatever. I mean, like I'd like to hang out with Vsauce. You know, like spend time with them because that's what a marriage is. You kind of have to like you're like shackled to this person. And like I can commit to Vsauce. Oh my god! No, I don't even wanna.
No! Let me reverse! Oh, come on! We're barely in the water! Fuck! Oh. I like how I scream.
This is the weirdest choice I've ever seen. Mary fuck kill. Justin Trudeau, Michael Fassbender, and Jeremy Irons.
I would rather the chat be something else, you know? It's just, like, it's so boring. None of them are funny to me.
Bill Gates, Oprah, or Anderson Cooper.
Wow, three names. It's like we're... The jokes in
Adam,
Mary Fuck Kill are like, hey, whoa, what happened to Mr. Interrupting all the time, complaining about being interrupted?
You're
just because I notice
me.
When I do it doesn't mean that it happens
okay,
more than one
go
time.
Ahead. Sorry.
The caliber of the jokes in Mary Fuck Kill are the same as like any one of those stupid Scary Movie 4 date movie, epic movie, disaster movie, those two assholes whose names I forget. And it's that caliber because literally the entire a kitty! Literally the entire joke is just pop culture reference celebrity name. Wow, that was so funny. Like, it's awful. It's just such shitty, bad
but
humor.
Adam, it's a game. So are you game shaming everybody? Just like I was with Pokemon Go?
For good reason. Yeah.
Oh! So there's good reason! So you need... Oh no! Okay, I'm dropping. I think it's funny. I don't know why you get like. It's kind of funny. Because, like, nobody who's writing these are taking it seriously, clearly.
Remember how angry his ass got? Especially with you bringing him into this shit.
Game Chambers. If Stretch was fucking with your boy LD, why he set us up with the deal for the break in the first place? He go off and make peace with the ballers, come back, and then put us on the lick on Grove Street.
Man, you remember Grove Street? Fuck!
You know what we should do? We would win the fight. That's a little more constructive.
Well, it involves, like, it makes sense, don't it? A hypothetical knowing, scenario, man. At Mr. least. Got in with the ballers when he was inside. And not just like, wow, I hate one of these people. So who do I want to fuck or marry the least? Whoa! I didn't even cause that! Yeah, thankfully.
Man, it wouldn't even be the same if your boy LD See, wasn't you're out saying, getting in like, the shit. So your fan LC fiction at Ori sucks because, like, Adam's a bottom and I'm a top. Man, I don't know. So, like, why am I getting gay? Well, don't tell me you didn't enjoy scrapping like we did back in the day. It ain't back in the day no more, dog. I see a flaw like in your story, okay, sir. I think you should do a little more research. Your useless ass one more fucking time. There you go. That wasn't too hard. You should have seen your face when I came in. You was like, shit, man. Oh, bullshit, nigga. You better check them draws, homie. You probably shitted yourself.
Fuck you,
who would
man.
Win in the fight? Cat? Cool cat? Or dog man? Army out there, nigga. They only send like two of the little. They're just like, I like how they can't do this.
It's like not even worth responding to. There's so many other better conversations to be had that the more we like respond to Mary Fuck Kill shit, the more we're just like.
Well, I wasn't. That was who would win in a fight.
Either of those are just awful. It's a good song though.
This is like instant pure depression music.
He's in several pieces right now.
Who would win in a fight? Gamergate or Black Lives Matter? Sorry. Okay, I'm done with it. I won't say anymore.
Okay.
I want to end on a bang. Kind of like my life. Can't wait. Okay, that one's kind of funny, but I'm not going to read it. Adam has a pretty hot persona. To be honest, I'd gape that.
Gape it. Nigga.
I guess what we learned is, nigga don't think it ain't no fun to be half fucking with the homies, nigga. You feel me, my nigga?
Hey, but I was real he's like shit, my nigga, completely fucked up, but he's still got his nigga, I humor. BAD, man. I like it. Lamar's like literally that friend that we've all had, like the dumbass who's like more like balls than brains. But he's like funny as fuck, damn, man, and he's a good friend, and you kind of keep him around. Thank you. I guess I'm Lamar. That's what I'm trying to say. Cars and shit, you know what I'm
talking about? Give a nigga just enough money to get him a little 40 ounce in a bucket of chicken on the way to the pole house, huh?
Man, don't be like that, dawg. Cause number one,
man, I want chicken now.
I never got paid for them motherfucking calls. Number two, I saved your motherfucking ass. No matter how many times you and that tiny motherfucking brain of yours have tried to get us killed, I saved you, dawg.
You supposed to, my nigga? I thought we was homies for life.
Me too, but I thought we was trying to get out of this bullshit. You live in a fantasy, homie. The best thing you can hope for is a big turnout for your motherfucking funeral.
Nigga, ain't nobody coming to your funeral.
What? Man, what about all the motherfucking times I saved your life, homie? What about that?
Oh, thank you, homie. Thanks for leaving your nigga in the backfield.
You know what, my nigga? If your ass can just act civilized, you would get some work. But instead, you want to be this gang-banging mad dog and asshole.
Oh, my bad, Mr. Goldcard. Excuse me, sir. Thank you for helping out a post-street nigga like me, sir. You can go now, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Whoa.
Who do you think I am, nigga?
Well, fuck you, Lamar.
Nah, fuck you, F, nigga. I thought we was homies, nigga. But that's some shit that just got past you, my nigga.
Saying that it's a bad thing that a white person wrote a scene like this is like saying that it's bad every time a not-trans person plays a trans character.
Nah. I think you're like,
well, I mean, saying it's like you have to
hey,
be.
Hey, so since you've decided to point me out every time that I interrupt you, and I haven't been for forever, I'm going to do it every single time now, so people can see that I don't
well, that's
do it more.
That's not changing anything. That's not changing anything. That's like the status quo.
Do you want to like rewind? I was literally in the middle. You didn't even hear what I wanted to say. Like, there's no excuse. Something that's gotta be. Hey, when the time what I was about to say is, hey, I think that you're kind of like preemptively interpreting something that isn't really that prevalent, because when people get mad at different races for either saying the N-word or for quote-unquote culturally appropriating, these types of people do not ever look up who a writer is. These types of people don't know who a director is. You know, it's like they're only going to pay attention to the color of the skin of the person actually saying it, whether it be the actor or, you know, character. They're not. When's the last time you ever heard of someone complaining like, oh, a white writer wrote the N-word in their script? Like, no one complains about that shit because, like, nobody pays attention to writers, you know? Nobody's gonna watch the second they feel like they should get offended watching a movie and are like, I should look up who the writer is to make sure he was black. By the end of the movie, they're not gonna remember, you know?
Sorry, but like, what does that relate to? Like comparison?
Well, no, because that's what you started talking about.
Because somebody said that in the comments. But like, they were
ironically
probably,
probably.
Yeah, no, exactly. I wasn't making like a real complaint.
Well, either way, I mean, like, point still stands that it's not very common that someone would get mad for.
I don't know. I don't think I've ever assumed that.
Well, whether it was ironic or satirical or not, like, it's a play on something that theoretically happens, right?
White people are all rapists. Facts. Check them.
She's leaving her own home. Oh, shit. Four!
I know you were being... No, don't worry. I know you were being ironic. He didn't do nothing. Oh, he's a baby boy. Can anybody help me hide a body? That game. Mark, have you seen Killer Joe? No?
Wow.
I don't think so.
This is a tough one.
No.
I hate when this happens.
187 was not their lucky number.
What?
What? That doesn't make any sense.
187, what's that?
Killing a cop. It's like officer down.
Hey, where's my stash of tequila?
I was thinking the same thing.
they just go right back to the tequila. Somebody else took the ambulance. Where are they going? Who took the ambulance is the real question. Ah!
We might be too late. It's him again. It's always him.
Where are you going?
Wait, 187?
Where's your tequila?
Wait, let me see. Let me see. Let me see. What is 187?
It don't worry me none.
Why is it when I type in 187, the first thing that comes up is 187 on an undercover hop? Because I don't... What? Oh, it's a brewing company. Oh. Oh, it's some shitty pun for like a brewing company. I walked into that one.
Fucking way!
Let's see.
Dick! Come on, move!
What, The unlawful killing of a human being. Oh, I guess it doesn't relate to just cops. I thought I kind of assumed it was supposed to be like an officer down or something.
Sure.
I'm an idiot. That's two blunders tonight. First, no tanks were in World War One, and then 187 means officer down.
All right, what's on my list of things I can do? Michael. Should probably return as Michael.
I don't hate Steven Universe, but there's like, it's not that great either. It's kind of overhyped and also kind of overly hated as well. It just falls in the middle somewhere. It's like the first season was pretty decent. And I swear to God, the animation got worse with the new seasons. Is that just me or like, everything seems a little bit more
I wish I could just sit.
Yeah, you know, just enjoy like a 40 with this guy.
Yeah.
I think that was like slight grease. Oh God, no! My baby boy, no!
I think they're coming in here. Oh shit!
The cops were right there. There was like 20 cops just waiting.
No, yeah, I didn't. Wasn't sure if they were gonna come inside.
I think he was bait, because they knew that.
They knew I couldn't resist.
Shit, come on, let's take him.
Sorry, wrong side. Ah! Whoa! Oh! Right in the direction, turns around like, I'm done here. I'm going home.
What do you think of We Bare Bears? I haven't seen it.
I don't care about Over the Garden Wall. It was alright. It didn't amaze me.
I fucking hate that one character. You know my thoughts on that bullshit. Gravity Falls, I don't want to give it the time of day.
They should put Black Lives Matter protesters in the next game.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't hear any news about Black Lives Matter at Pride.
Well, I'm hoping they reach some sort of agreement beforehand.
I guess, like, I can only assume that's a good thing.
It was the... I guess, was the police float there? I guess we'll find out. I am gay. What's what?
More groups choose to sit out of the Vancouver Pride Parade. What about the kids?
Sorry, what? What is the headline you're reading?
Hold on.
Something don't feel too good.
I'm Black Lives Matter about to do some sit-ins on this highway. Nope, stealing your car. Shouldn't have stopped. If you just searched for like Vancouver Pride 2016 police float.
I did.
And what'd you find?
I'm reading the first article, so let me read.
Okay.
It does look like they sat out.
Really?
Yep.
That's awful.
So did two other like floats or like.
There's no reason for that. Don't get bullied. Fuck. Like, are they just waiting until it calms down? How many years later is Black Lives Matter going to say that police floats and pride parades are okay?
Maybe I'm wrong. Hold on. I'm just going to read into this. I'm like, that was one site. Now I'm going to another.
Yeah, what site was that?
CBC. This is Metro Vancouver. I think the one I was reading was past tense. It sounded like they were gonna like sit out. But it didn't like actually. It sounded past tense.
Oh yeah, look at the dates. Oh.
Yeah, it was past tense.
So they were considering it, or like.
Yeah. So it like it looked. So it sounded like they were gonna sit out, but it doesn't actually say whether or not they were there or not. Vancouver police make concession, but Black Lives Matter won't march.
Hey, right, Waffles right? Here.
How are you?
What is the date? It's just a simple article.
Oh, I need to return as Michael. Fuck, I thought I was gonna meet up with Michael. Shit. Ah, whatever. When you're done that, we should let Waffle know if there's any good, thing to animate.
Okay.
Because Waffle is here.
Waffle. That sweet I would stick my tongue in that sweet, tasty waffle. You know what I'm talking about.
Oh my god, what the fuck is this?
It is me.
Something about UFOs.
Yeah, there's like a UFO worshiping cult.
I know there's a lot of like UFO Easter eggs and stuff and like parts and
yeah,
but I'm not sure like how extensive.
I think this is the cult that people were referring to was very similar to the Clefairies in that episode we made.
Oh yeah,
yeah. There is a real life
spaceship part
cult that like worships aliens. They're like, come take us.
That's pretty cool.
Waffle is best animator. I like Waffle style. I'm not just saying that because they're here. Now. I genuinely like Waffle style.
So did you find out anything? Or?
No,
I guess I'll look it up later.
I got bored. There's too many words.
Okay. Was there any scene that you had off the top of your head? And the reason why I asked Waffle to come into this chat is because I figured chat might have some input as to like what kind of things exist on the channel that would be kind of cool to animate or have animated.
I only had like that one suggestion, but you know what it was. So
okay.
Animate Mark and Adam fighting over Pokemon Go. Talking about the ethics in Pokemon Go.
Yes, Kaufman. But these things take time. There's a lot of things I plan to do that. Forgive me. Ah! This old man. He's so fucking old! Ah!
Come on, you piece of shit!
Good lord above. Yeah, that's all you need. Is just to threaten them with a weapon like that. They'll piss off. Alright, I will return as Michael to do the mission. Have I ever received unsolicited dick pics? Yeah, all the time. So. I mean, God damn it! Oh, this is awful. This is so bad! No, yeah, I know that shit about Life is Strange. I mean, so if there's any, like, funny sequence, because I mean, the animation. Where did my car go? It just disappeared. I was about to nudge it. Fuck. And I hate this song too. Ugh. This isn't any better. So it doesn't necessarily have to be, something that is
funny,
a fan fiction. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be.
Wait, what about fan fiction?
We're talking about what Waffle should animate next. Where are you?
I'm not here.
Now.
Shit.
When Waffle's drawing of Elena is hotter than actual Elena. Yeah, there's some juicy stuff in Until Dawn.
Because, I mean, you could always, like, reenact scenes that we could still already see with the video games. Like, they don't always have to be, like, hypothetical scenarios.
Sorry.
Woo!
What about hypotheticals?
Well, that's what we have so far, is just hypothetical fanfiction scenarios, right? Whereas the... Oh! That's, what a pro!
That's true. Wow. What a great cop. Man.
I ain't got a train to catch. Shit. I got a fox to catch.
Have Waffle animate the nerve dare for Adam. That was pretty good. I think that's an animation right there. Be quick and simple. Just have like an old like colored iMac from like 2006. Or actually, no, wait, that was like maybe that was. It was something like 2003 or some shit.
Yeah, the funny meter thing would actually be pretty cool. Because like, the, you could like animate killing a squirrel in some unique way. Or...
I think there's plenty of juicy stuff in Until Dawn. What else is like our older series? There's got to be a good Heavy Rain one there too.
Plenty.
There's got to be something, at least even like the first episode of like Heavy Rain.
Like even if you just took something that wasn't guaranteed gold, I'm sure you could turn it into something that.
Yeah, that's the power of animation.
Funny. Yeah. They give freedom to do whatever you want, really.
Mark is a cutie. Leave him alone. Thank you, Pro Waffles. You're a cutie, too. I'd like to get in that boat. But I'm not going to say. Sorry. An animation of Dog Man. That's... See, the thing is like, you'd want to like hire like Studio Ghibli for that. Like, you need a whole team to work on Dog Man. but to kill this Dog Man right here. Bye, doggy. Just get your gun, do it. Get the sniper rifle. Bye, doggy. Go to sleep now. Just oops. Completely mad. I'm so mad. Oh, he's dead dog. Why did you have to die? Why? Why is the world so cruel? I like how you kicked it once. It's like a blood pinata. It's just like,
yeah.
Oh my god, blood everywhere. Big blood sausage.
Bye, doggy.
Hey, bye, doggy. You're a good boy. I feel like Mark smells like Axe. I think that's the best diss anybody said to me.
That's good.
This is just saying, like, yeah, he looks like the kind of guy that smells like Axe is, like, actually, like, the best burn.
Who's the oldest guy I've hooked up with? Probably in his, like, 50s or 60s. It was an experiment.
It was alright. No, I wish I could do the female equivalent of that. But it's like way harder.
Hillary Clinton.
Ugh.
How old is she actually though?
She doesn't have a vagina. She just has a fucking black hole. I meant, you know, not the, okay, well. Mark is a cutie. If I was gay, his boy pussy would be mine. XD, XD. Axe body spray. There was one time.
I don't even, like, sorry.
What are you gonna say?
I'm trying to respond to the animation shit. They're saying towel boy, but I don't.
Oh my god!
I don't think that. Like, what about it would. Like, what.
That'd be really
what
simple.
Is it even. Like, where do we find this quote, even?
Oh my god. Well, the last one. What was the last really long towel boy one? We were playing, like, Insider? No. What were we playing? Fuck.
You'd be surprised what's safe for YouTube.
Ooh, towel boy. Looks like you have to use a really big towel. Oh, yes, master. I think, like, I could just, like, bust out a towel boy at any point, though. They're pretty much, like, they're very formulaic. They're like, towel boy has to do something very, like, submissive and, like, slave boyish. And I'm towel boy's master. I don't know. Oh, Beyond Two Souls, when we did the renaming of movies to towels.
We can think of something better.
No, that's not very good, like, animation-wise. Really, it's pretty stagnant. You could get away with, like, still images through Photoshop, not animation.
No.
I would just love to see what, like, Waffle would do with Talboy. Like, what would I never describe what Talboy looks like, but just based on, like, his character, like, what would Talboy look like? Like, what's your interpretation of Talboy? I think that's kind of funny. I'd like to see that out of curiosity's sake, but you could just get no more than, like, a still image. Talboy versus Dogman. It's the movie I'm destined to make, really. Do you bleed, dog man? You will. And you'll probably need a towel to clean it up, too. What's Zack and Snyder gonna do next? What's next for Snack Snyder? Snack on Snyder. Cider. A tiny blonde tween, pretty much. I think I imagine Talboy is like this, like, little submissive twink boy. Who's, like, really nervous and, like, dropping towels all over the place. Because his hands are so shaky. Uh-oh. Looks like you dropped that towel, Talboy. Looks like you have to bend over and pick it up. Oh, yes, master. No, face the other way, Talboy. Away from me. Yes, master. God damn it, Talboy.
Whew. Yeah.
Get me nice and sweaty. Like,
I feel like if you just go through the actual, like, Adam Plays series, any one of the recent ones with good mic quality, anything you feel that would be good to put as an animation, I think we trust that it'll turn out good. Because I'm, like, as a person who's not an animator, it's difficult to try and, like, envision what would work.
Well, I think when we give a lot to, like, work with, I guess. Like, or, like, created scenarios of, like, I shouldn't be, like, fan fiction all the time, but it's, like, it is funny when we kind of build these scenarios, I guess. And I think, like, animation-wise, that's, like, a lot to work with. I guess I'm trying to assume. I'm not an animator. But
the funny meter parts were within the first four parts, I'm pretty sure. Like, there's parts of it If you want to go all the way to, like, the secretly I'm depressed part with a funny meter, I think that's in part 4.
The story I made in Job Sim? Oh, you mean the mechanic.
It has kind of shit audio, but...
Yeah. Well, you said the story you made in Job Simulator. Did I tell a story?
No, I think they're just saying, like...
The story I made up of this character, this piece of shit mechanic who's, like, jerking off all the time. That's what they mean, I guess?
Yeah, I think that's what they mean.
Okay. Yeah. I mean...
Ah! It's gone!
I might do some more, like, solo Dying Light videos, I don't know. Who knows? I talked about me getting up on stage and stuff. Are you talking about that, like, I like my women like I like my coffee joke?
Nah.
That I said in front of my school? I like how you said, nah.
Well, yeah, I mean, like, what could you benefit from animating it in that you couldn't already visualize, you know? To make something work well animated, there needs to be something that it could benefit from being animated, you know?
Marvel could draw me in front of my school. No, oh my god!
I don't see that being better animated.
Have you met any celebrities? I met Keanu Reeves. Rick Mercer. Rob Stark from Game of Thrones. I forget his name. Something Madden. Was it Rob Stark? I don't know. It's like one of those. I think actually Rob Stark is like Sean Bean. And one of his kids in that show. Something Madden.
Ah! He cut me off.
Both Rick Mercer and John Madden, the actor from Game of Thrones who plays like the son of Stark, King of the North, you know that guy. They both ordered some really fucking weird pizzas too. Like Rick Mercer, like specifically got us to get a special sausage and like slice it up and cook it into like it wasn't even on the menu and like he like. Like, not in a mean way, but he was, like, very, like, you know, he, like, not in a mean way. It doesn't sound, like, there's no way it can sound not mean, but, like, kind of demanded that we do it, but, it wasn't mean. It's just, I guess he just knew he could get away with it. He's like, I'm Rick Mercer, make me a pizza. And I was like, you're a small man. We're about the same height. We literally were the exact same height. And then, John Snow would like order a margarita pizza, no cheese, so it's bread in like marinara sauce, and then order, I'm not even fucking shitting you, like something like 5 to 10 cups, like to go cups worth of truffle oil, and he would pour it on his pizza to the point where it was a soup. It was like it was drowning in truffle oil. Like, I don't even know if he actually liked the taste of truffles. If, like, it might have been, like, a money thing. Like, I'm so rich, I can afford all this truffle oil. I'm just gonna dump it on a pizza. No, I don't know. Maybe he just has a really specific taste. But, like, that was, like, it was actually, like, gross looking. Like, no offense to him. I mean, like, I like Hawaiian pizza, and some people think that's, like, a sin against God for pizza goes. So, everybody has their taste. And truffle's great, so... If I had that kind of money, fuck yeah. Around my food and truffle oil. Wrong time to cross. Fuck, who else? I don't know. What celebrities have you met?
It's a stun gun. I want to see what happens.
Okay. Max Landis? Met him. Keanu Reeves was with his band Dogstar, and he was just chilling out, and he's like literally like the most He's literally, he actually is, like, the most chill dude you've ever met in your entire life. Like, any assumptions you probably had about Keanu Reeves is, like, completely true. Except for that one guy in chat who constantly assumes he's a rapist. I mean, I couldn't confirm or deny, but it just seems like... Is Rick Mercer nice? He's coming to my school in the fall. Well, yeah, the general sense I got of Rick Mercer is that he's pretty nice. He just, like, he was very specific about
his pizza. It's a stun gun, calm down.
I didn't complain. I had a very, very short-lived chat with him. It was like, basically asked him, like, how his day was going. Like, just, you know, like
fluff. The stun gun doesn't do anything, does it?
Maybe you have to be really close. Those things have a limit, because they have, like, wires that shoot out. Adam hasn't seen The Nice Guys.
Yeah, I haven't seen it.
Matthew, oh yeah, Matthew Santoro.
There we go.
When I met Matthew Santoro. Oh, doggy! Night, night. Oh no! He's biting his butt!
Why does the other guy not get up?
Yeah, when I met Matthew Santoro in person, he literally pulled out like a portfolio, like a whole like booklet. Full of like pictures of like naked little babies, and he's like, "Wow, look at me! I love babies so much." And he waved out a stick, and he started drinking it right there. I was like, "Matthew, I don't think you should do that in like out in public." He's like, "What are they gonna do? Arrest Matthew Santoro, the most famous YouTuber of all?" And the cops did. They didn't do anything. They were scared of him.
This could be animated. Just as I'm like tasing a dog.
What are they gonna do? Prosecute a baby?
No, not the doggy. You met Carl Weathers?
In the eye!
Mark, would you fuck Chloe Morgan? Mortez?
Oh, you're a good... Oh, get back here!
You bad dog.
No, I wouldn't. Part of it literally is Warful.
Would you animate that for me, Warful?
All right, let's do this thing.
Part of what's, like, unattractive about her is the fact that she isn't a good actress.
Oh, so I can... This, like, knocks people out, I guess. Okay, interesting. I thought they would have just gotten back up.
Matthew Santoro has a very specific fetish where he doesn't actually, like, rape the children himself with his penis or anything. He just, like, he greases up his bald head and then wears them like a hat. And then he walks around downtown naked and says, What are you gonna do? Stop Matthew Santoro, the world's busiest music nerd, the internet's busiest music nerd. Matthew Santoro and like Anthony Fanbrango, do like the fusion dance and then become one, and they basically look like exactly the same, but he's wearing glasses now. and then proceeds to like find every boy and girl and like viciously molest them.
Assault with a deadly weapon. Bullshit, this is a stun gun.
Matthew Fantoro.
We are not Matthew Santoro or Anthony Fantano no more. We are Matthew Fantoro, the strongest there is.
Oh no. It might very well be time to stop commenting on life. Man, I could really go for some death grips and also a rape.
They call my butthole the death grips.
Results in moronic comments posted below it. The internet is a k-hole. Turn
A K-hole.
And then Nathany Fantoro like goes Super Saiyan, instead he just turns into like, oh fuck, what's that character's name again? Like Seth or whatever the fuck, he just puts on the mustache and gets like squinty eyed.
Mm-hmm.
What's his name? That stupid alternative, like that alter ego of his.
It's not, oh, like, I don't know.
Stupid, it's just like his, it's his thing.
I need to change into my tuxedo.
You know what? Saying Animal Collective was never good is just your opinion, man. Because they are good, and I approve. Sorry.
Where's Ponzi Boys? Where's my tuxedo? It's at home, right? Where's my home? Damn it. Oh, wait, no, I need to get it from here. Oops. Sorry. This is my first objective.
Adam, Charlie or Lloyd, which is the strongest Kaufman?
What do you define as strong?
Is it wrong to be strong? No, that's not true. If you, like, to say Animal Collective was good only in the early 2000s, that's when they were their strongest. But, like Painting With was actually good. It's actually a good album. I would have said that to you a year ago, maybe. But like they've definitely proven themselves to still like they still have the magic, you know. Even their solo stuff is getting better. I can completely agree. Like Panda Bear's newest album was like fucking fantastic. And like, I think all the members of Animal Collective are like okay on their own, but they're obviously better when they actually get together. But like, Centipede Hurts was just such a like meh album. I remember listening to it the first time and like, it was just kind of, it like literally my reaction was just kind of meh, and then I kept listening to it and it just like never changed. Whereas like with most Animal Collective albums, it's a complete like opposite reaction. It's like I don't know what to think at first. And then I keep listening. And then it's like each listen gets better and better. I don't even know what Pitchfork is. What?
Alright. My asshole does have death grips, I swear.
Bye, enjoy your purchase.
Oh, crap!
What? The movie? What? I'm still. What? Come on! I just wanted to kill her! Ugh.
You ruined it.
Okay, I need to. Well, this was a generous checkpoint. That's all I gotta say.
I can see you wearing that.
Well, I need to equip it.
I don't know what your question was, actually. So. When I missed your comment or your question, and then the you write Mark, I know you saw my comment. It's like, no, I didn't.
Are we finished?
Whoa. That got too real.
Whoa.
My stretch limo. How dare you, Jimmy? Your head.
The premiere will be ruined, though. But
Mark, thoughts on Seth Rogen?
This doesn't ruin the premiere, though.
Would I rather fuck my mom or Hillary Clinton? Well, one would be awkward, and the other would be incest.
Oh!
I'm reloading!
Who wears shorts?
This is your
suit?
Big day. Are you seriously
Jimmy.
Trying to ruin it?
The Oriental Theater.
Get me out. You can't
Open
leave.
Champagne.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, Adam, would you fuck Frank?
J-Rock
Jeff.
I don't know who that is. I don't know who that is. That's why I haven't answered you. I'm sorry.
I'm surprised Jonah Hill didn't.
So this is where I ran over all these other people.
Oh, wow. Look at those cameras. White lenses. Wow. I mean, like, come on. Really? You're like, you're pretty close up. You don't need a zoom lens, you fucking idiot. Look at these, like, look at these amateurs.
But you need to tell them to get their head out of their fucking ass and fire your ass. Are you joking me? Come on.
Hi, Jimmy.
Milton and Charlie.
Jonah Hill gay? Yes.
I love Jonah Hill, actually.
I do.
Have you ever thought maybe I shouldn't shoot sex scenes in a green screen kind of environment? Yeah, yeah, it's the thought has crossed my mind, I suppose. Where the fuck are you? And have you ever shot in France? I heard that you like to do a lot of European artsy stuff. Yeah, yeah, France, you know, the land of art.
He's the guy that popularized on the red carpet, a
meltdown.
Okay.
Some big stars, some beautiful dresses. We're gonna see some side boot tonight.
Woohoo!
We did it! Solomon!
We fucking did it!
Sully!
Hey!
Hey!
Superbad's pretty good. Not amazing, it's pretty good.
On Vinewood Boulevard. I'll see you in there, kid.
Hey,
Mark, can
thanks.
You pass me that white remote?
Enjoy the picture, to the left of the table.
Mr. Richards, hi. If I could just bother you for a second. I'm Laszlo from Fame or Shame.
Fuck.
I do some acting on the side. I was wondering if...
Oh, yeah, of course. You should come see me, kid. I think I got a project that would be perfect for you.
Oh, that's fantastic. It's called The Closet.
Movies
really
were a mistake.
Pervert. Come on.
No.
Let's go over
She's
here.
Lying, okay? I never had surgery. Come on.
Milton, hi. Sorry to bother you. Quick question. Get in here tight.
Get in here tight, huh?
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
When you were that
it's the premiere.
Does nostalgia play a factor?
Sorry,
somewhat.
That was emotional. Can I just have a hug? That really affected
But,
me.
I mean, it's also, like, the
so
first
much.
Of its generation.
Come on, let's get in there.
Superbad was, like,
yeah,
what inspired The Hangover and so many other movies of that caliber and genre and with
Looks
those
like
actors
did,
sort of
yeah.
thing.
I'm not too late. I wouldn't miss this for the world.
Devin, the fuck are you doing?
Devin!
Hey, what a movie, huh? Meltdown. Congratulations, Mikey. We did it. Hey, let's get a picture, huh? You, me, the proud producer. Such a pleasure working with you. You see, I was here. Unlike your wife. Seems to
I hate Chloe.
Stuck at home.
Twisted fuck. You're a dead man. Let's go, Jim. Come on.
Hold on! Where's Mom and Tracy?
The girls are in danger. We gotta go to the house.
Well, let me.
Alright, let's do this.
I like how they're just like.
Yeah, they're
like,
not. They don't exist as real. I'm supposed
it's
to
like
not
they're playing
go
Pokemon
that way.
Go!
Sorry. Reloading. Because I'm supposed to not go that way.
No, I don't really find her attractive. I mean, like, maybe objectively she's attractive, but like. I don't have a thing for. I don't even know what. Like.
Jimmy!
Jimmy.
My baby boy.
It's not.
What's
it's
happening?
Less to do with, like.
I'm gonna grab another piece of hoagie.
I just have this feeling that, like, there's nothing really to her as a person. Especially. Are you gonna have some of that fruit?